So what is it like being famous? What does it look like from the inside? In New York City, I met with former US Secret Service agent Scott Alswang. Over his 20-year career, Scott protected Presidents Clinton, Reagan, and Bush W. and Sr. Scott has personally provided security for Bono, U2, Beyonce, Jay-Z, Katy Perry, Lady Gaga, Madonna, Bruce Springsteen, and Sting.
I handled Madonna for the MTV Music Awards years ago in L.A. And we went to an after party, and in all my years of being with celebrities and presidents, I'd never seen a room like this.
With the Scorpions, we met pretty much everybody. Sting, Mick Jagger, you know, like AC/DC. I mean, we had like Alice Cooper opening that for us. We did a tour with Bon Jovi, of course. I met a lot of times because Bon Jovi actually got famous opening up for the Scorpions.
I was there. My friend was there with Bruce Springsteen, his bodyguard, Tim McGraw and Faith Hill, and Bono's security guy. So we're all there kind of hanging out because we had an eye on the room, and that room was the most jam-packed room of celebrities I'd ever been in.
So I've gotten to work with Dustin Hoffman in Death of a Salesman. We did the play and the film version, and I've worked with Brando, as I said, and I think Matthew Broderick is quite a genius in his way, and Sean Penn.
Frank Sinatra. I had the best time of my life with him.
The last thing, long extended run, was I did Phantom of the Opera, actually in Las Vegas, for 6.5 years playing the Phantom.
I wouldn't say it changed my life or the way that I do things, but it was certainly nice to watch the Academy Awards and really, you know, be rooting for something that you were a part of. I mean, that's pretty cool.
We were the keeper of the secrets, so you looked at our parents as famous, but we saw the warts. But if we ever talked about the warts, you would take us to the shed and spank us, if you would. Because people enjoy putting people on pedestals.
Here are all my press passes for Capitol Hill, the White House. I guess I'm probably best known as being the reporter that broke the Michael Jackson story.
This is the hat he wore during Billie Jean. I bought this after I first broke the Michael Jackson story, and I thought, well, that's it. I broke that story. That's enough of that. It's all over. Oh, look, I'll buy that. And then, of course, the story never ended.
You can touch the hat. Go ahead. Put the hat if you want. I don't care.
Because it's quite amazing, isn't it?
How yet
it's like, we know he's a man. We know he was just human, but yet, wow, it's the hat, and it's the Billie Jean hat.
Mm-hmm. And it's got his name embossed in gold right here, and then the signature.
Yeah. Ooh. So this is the...
Do you feel famous?
I don't feel like Michael Jackson.
Oh, very nice. Now, can you moonwalk back?
In different shoes.
I want to become so famous that I have to walk around with security from like crazy fans.
It's as if we missed one email or one moment to be on the internet, we would become irrelevant.
You're more part of history with fame than you are by just leading your life. And that is the seduction.
And it's the immediacy that I think is driving us to anxiety disorders.
When you're sitting there refreshing your phone constantly to see, yes, it's very addicting. No, not at all. Nothing's authentic on social media.